Okay, Dr. Mindy here, and with my reset tip for you for today. You know, as many of you know that have been following me, I coach a lot of people, really, really sick people, back to health, and there's a lot of pieces that we put together in order for people to get well. And I use a lot of the tools that I use. I'm teaching you guys here on Facebook and in my resetter group. And I'm a big believer in the ketogenic diet. And one of the things that I have learned in watching all these people go through different ways of clicking into ketosis, different ways of lowering blood sugar, is that everybody has a unique path to a low blood sugar, high ketone. And there are four things that will block you from getting that lower blood sugar. So a lot of you guys are doing the blood sugar readers and you're looking at it and you're seeing that your numbers are still really high. So I want you to think about four things. The first is that you definitely, this is very, very classic, when people go low carb, sometimes they forget to go high fat. So one trick for lowering blood sugar is make sure that you're going high fat. The other thing I would tell you on that is make sure your protein isn't too high. So a lot of people are going low carb, high fat, but they're still doing their protein really high. I recommend your protein's under 50 grams. So the first thing is to look at your diet and just know that you've got your ratios right to get that blood sugar low, okay? Second thing, neurotoxic people will always have high blood sugar regardless of what they do with their nutrition. So if you're fasting and you're keeping your carbs down and eating your high fat and you're still coming up with these high blood sugar numbers, you gotta start thinking about heavy metals, pesticides, glyphosate, things like that will have a dramatic effect on your blood sugar. So make sure that you've either done a heavy metal test, make sure that you are implementing some type of heavy metal detoxing. Okay, third thing, what we're starting to see is that sometimes there can be like gut bacteria, that pathogens like Candida that will give off exotoxins. And exotoxins will go in and they'll block those receptor sites that for insulin and glucose. So test your gut. Know if you have Candida, know if you have SIBO or a parasite that also can throw your blood sugar off. And then the last thing is something that I discovered actually just today. A patient of mine is having a really positive reaction with taking enzymes before at night. She's noticing that her blood sugar is lower in the morning. So here's what enzymes do. Until your gut is healthy, enzymes help break down food so your body can assimilate it easier. So things like we use this to, we use to help break down meat. So some of you that are not good at breaking down meat, and one way you would know that is you just feel really bloated after you eat. Those of you that are gluten intolerant and you're not good at breaking down gluten, try Z-gluten. The one that's working for this patient of mine is NZ, is really helpful for breaking down carbs. So again, if you're struggling to get that number down, you're doing all the other things, have you tried NZ? Because that will help bring it down. And then my favorite overall enzyme for just, you're not sure what enzyme you need, is D-digest. So it's a lot of pieces, and what I want to get across to you is that low blood sugar means health. And when your blood sugar goes low, your ketones will go high and your body's healing. But how do you make that happen is unique to you. So check out those four things. If you've done 1, 2, and 3, it's time to think about throwing some enzymes in. If you haven't done the first three and you throw enzymes in, you may not get as good of a reaction. So I definitely gave it to you in the order in which I would do it. So nutrition first, I would then look at heavy metals, then I would look at pathogens, and then I would look at enzymes. So I hope that helps. If you're struggling with your blood sugar, just let me know where you struggle. I'm here to assist you. So have an awesome day.